We will solve problem 26, chapter 11 of H.C. Verma. In this problem, we have been given with a situation where if we place a mass attached to a spring at equator, there is certain extension x. We have to find out at what height above the surface of the earth we should place the same system with the same spring and same mass so that extension doesn't change. Extension is again x. You have to keep in mind that the forces acting in this situation and this situation are different, because here you have to take into account the centrifugal force also. Here there is no centrifugal force, so you have to keep it above a certain height h so that the extension is same. Now, before we go to that, the problem, we should find out the expression for the value of g at height h. Let it be g dash, and let the value of g at the surface be g0, which is 9.8. We know that m g0 is equal to g m upon r square. At height h, it would be m g dash is equal to g m upon r plus h whole square. Divide these two relationships, we get g0 upon g dash is equal to r plus h upon r whole square, or g dash upon g0 is equal to 1 plus h upon r raised to power minus 2. Since this is a very small number, because h is very very small in comparison to r, we apply the binomial relationship, it becomes 1 minus twice h upon r. So g dash is equal to g0 1 minus twice h upon r. So this is the relationship between the gravity at the height h and gravity at the surface. It is a standard equation which should be otherwise also be known for solving the problems. Let us write it in a different form. G dash is equal to g0 minus g0 twice h upon r. So g0 minus g dash becomes g0 twice h upon r. g0 minus g dash is equal to g0 twice h upon r. So we will use this relationship. Now let us write the force equation for this situation. Let us have a free body diagram. What is the force acting towards the center? It is mg0 towards the center of the earth. Then the centrifugal force will be radially outwards. It is mr omega square, where r is the radius. And there is another force which is because of the extension of spring, it is kx. So the equation becomes mr omega square plus kx is equal to mg0. This is the equation for equator. In case of pole, it is very simple. There is no other force, only mg dash in this direction and kx in the upward direction. So kx in the upward direction, mg dash in the downward direction, and it is in equilibrium. So kx is equal to mg dash, and this is mg0. So place the value of kx here, so it becomes mr omega square plus mg dash is equal to mg0. M gets cancelled and it becomes g0 minus g dash, which we have found. This is g0 minus g dash. It becomes r omega square is equal to g0 minus g dash, which is equal to g0 twice h upon r. So you can solve this equation now straight away. It becomes mr omega square is equal to g0 twice h upon r. Place the values. Omega is how much? Omega is 2 pi divided by t. T will be 24 hours into 60 minutes into 60 seconds. That is, these many seconds are taken for completing one rotation about the axis. So by this we know the omega. We know the value of r is 6400 kilometers. We know the value of g0 is 9.8. We place the values here and we get h as approximately 10 kilometers. So this is the answer, and that solves the problem. Thank you.